Guys, I got all ready for this video, and guess what I did? Sent the files over to my computer, and then I deleted them. And then I went into my trash bin and deleted them there, too. I don't know why. Sometimes I just do stupid shit. So, I'm going to try to redo this video and make it sound like it's off the top of my head. But I've already done it once. But let's try again. Let's take two.
You stupid, ignorant son of a bitch, dumb bastard!
It's time, we're back again, and we're going to talk toys. Oh, no, not another toy video. It's like the 10th one this month. Sorry, I like toys. But we're going to talk about reproduction action figures. What's a reproduction action figure? Well, it's a fancy word for big pile of horse shit.
That is one big pile of shit.
But to keep my mind on track, we're going to keep it to the Star Wars vintage line, because this is what I know. But you'll find reproduction action figures online of Superpowers, Ninja Turtles, Star Trek, of course Star Wars, about anything in the world. And, well, I've never seen a reproduction of a Dash Rendar Shadows of the Empire figure. But hey, I've never really Google searched a Dash Rendar Shadows of the Empire reproduction figure, so they're probably out there. Reproductions are flooding eBay. So what is a reproduction? It's a fake. That's right. It's when someone makes their own lightsaber or gun or cape or even the card. That's right. A card can be reproduction. That's right. They can be fake ones. This is a real Princess Leia Bosch action figure. So it's not a good example of reproduction, but people will print out these cards. Get them about a $30, $40 figure, stick it on the card with a new bubble, sell it as a reproduction, and a couple hundred dollar figure becomes a $50, $60 figure. And it looks almost identical, unless you know what to look for. It even feels authentic. But I know what you're saying. You're saying, hey, Star Wars junk. I don't have hundreds of dollars to throw down on a toy. After all, it's just for my collection. No one's going to know. The seller tells me what it is, so he's not ripping me off. So it's a win-win for everybody. Wrong! It's a lose-lose! It sucks! Don't do it!
Ooh, my bad.
But I did do it. I bought a figure. It's not reproduction, but it's been re-glued. Now you're asking yourself, Star Wars junk, you told us not to do it and you did it. What kind of bullshit is that? Well, I got it really cheap. And it's you can really tell that it's been re-glued. I wish I would have turned his head, but whoever didn't, but it's a bad job, so no one's going to sell this on eBay as a real item. Trust me. You can look at it even in a photo and tell it's not that it's been recorded. And if someone online says it's reproduction, why does it matter? Well, believe it or not, some people on eBay and the internet are dishonest.
What?
Yep, it's true. There's some dishonest people out there. Now, there's a lot of eBay ads that will say it's a reproduction, but sometimes some people don't know. Or they just mislead everyone. So let's not support reproductions. If there's a supply and demand for reproduction items, they're gonna be on eBay. So if we don't buy them, no one's gonna make them and sell them.
You rebel scum.
But again, you might be asking yourself, why is it bad if you're gonna do it for your own personal collection? Well, for my personal reason for not doing it, is it takes the fun out of it. I started collecting loose Star Wars figures back in the 90s, and it took me almost 10 years to get a complete set. Let's take a look at this Stormtrooper. Haha, I fooled you. It's not a Stormtrooper, it's Luke Skywalker as a Stormtrooper. And it took me almost 10 years after I stopped collecting to find this helmet. Yep, I bought this one probably about 1995, and it was probably about 2005, 2006 before I found a helmet for it that was at a reasonable price that I could afford. Luckily, eBay came around. Back when I started collecting, I had to go to local comic shops, toy shows, or buy a toy shop magazine which had ads to order stuff. You didn't know what you were getting. You had to even write a check or a mail order and mail it off. It took you months to get what you ordered, and it might not have been what you wanted. But you didn't have to worry about reproduction back then, as you do now. Now, with 3D printers, home computers, reproductions can be made by almost anyone. Anyone with talent is. I'm sure I couldn't do it.
I have no talent.
But it takes the fun out of it. Why are you in such a hurry to get a complete set? Take your time. Drag it out. Trust me, if you spend the time and get a 100% authentic collection, you're going to be a lot happier with your collection. But what about those Carter figures that cost thousands of dollars? A lot of people can't throw down that kind of money. That's right, that's why I don't collect carded, because I can't bring myself to pay hundreds of thousands of dollars for an action figure. Now, I know what you're saying, but you got carded figures. That's right, if I see a deal on one, I'll buy it. If I'm able to trade something for it, I'll take it. But I can't throw down hundreds of dollars for a Bosch. Bought this for about $30. I can afford $30 sometime. So that's what you do. You buy what you can, buy doubles. You get to know other collectors. Make deals, make trades, and then your collection will grow, and it will not cost you as much as you're thinking it will.
11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77, 78, 79, 80, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, 100, 101, 102, 103, 104, 105, 106, 107, 108, 109, 110, 111, 112, 113, 114, 115, 116, 117, 118, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37,
buy reproduction, you know what it is, so the seller didn't rip you off. What's the big deal? Well, one day you're going to die. Sad but true, you're going to die. Now, I know what you're saying. My wife isn't going to sell my collection. I'm giving my collection to my kids. Okay, fine. What about after that? One day your grandkids are going to inherit it. And sooner down the line, somebody's going to sell it. All your grandkids are going to remember about Grandpa is that he used to babble about Star Wars and he used to shit himself. They're not going to know which figure had a reproduction weapon, which card figure was real, which one wasn't. They're going to throw it up on eBay or sell it at an estate sale. And then your reproduction figures going to end up in some collector's hands as the real thing. Someone's going to pay thousands of dollars for items they believe are authentic. When they're not, you're just ripping them off. And the market's going to get flooded with it.
No way, this is bogus, man.
There's been millions of times I've seen online childhood collection of my dad's selling it. Or, these were mine glowing up. Everything's 100% real. And they're not. There's a reproduction in there. So, as I said before, not everybody on the internet is honest, or they're not knowledgeable. So, maybe they're not trying to rip you off. But imagine getting ripped off. Imagine if you threw out thousands of dollars for a set, only to discover that 60, 70% of it is reproduction stuff. So, what you thought was worth thousands is already worth hundreds at the most. And now I know what you're thinking. Well, I'm not in this to get rich. I'm not in this for the money, Phil. But let's be honest. If you invest your time and money into it, hopefully you're going to get it back one day, or at least your grandkids or their grandkids, somebody's going to end up selling it and getting back with all the hard work you put into it.
Show me the money.
So if you're just starting out collecting, take it slow. Don't be in a rush to complete your set. Make sure you get authentic stuff or try your best to, and when you find out you didn't, burn it and dig a hole and bury it. Get rid of it so no one ever has to see it again. I've been collecting Star Wars for over 20 years, and I bought a Luke Jedi with a blue lightsaber on eBay a few years ago. And believe me, I thought it was a real lightsaber for a year until I get ready to trade it on a message board. People freaked out like I was trying to rip them off. But honestly, I didn't know. I never really paid that much attention to it. Then when I did some of the simple tests you can do, like if it floats on water, lo and behold, I had a fake lightsaber. Yep, I paid money for a phony lightsaber. Still pissed off about that.
It's all Obi-Wan's fault.
And again, if you got reproduction stuff, burn it and bury the ashes. Let's get rid of it. And don't buy reproduction on eBay. All it does is create a supply and demand. And if they think they can make money off of it, they're going to be flooded with more reproductions. And it's going to kill the market. So please, stay away from reproduction items. And this includes not just fake lightsabers, fake capes, fake guns, or fake back cards. Also stay away from decals that's been reprinted, like the stickers on RG-D2. Stick to the authentic stuff. Or try your best to. Now, I've had some people ask me, what's the difference between a custom figure and a reproduction figure? Man, that's pretty simple. Let's say you take a Boba Fett and cut his head off and put it on a Stormtrooper and make a combination of a Boba Fett Trooper. That's a custom because it was never in the official kennel line. And there's no such thing as a Boba Fett Stormtrooper. Now, let's say you take the Stormtrooper and somehow put a Luke Skywalker head on it and have a helmet with it. Then that will be a reproduction because there was an official Luke Skywalker stormtrooper. So, customs, when you make up something of your own that was never in the line, and a reproduction is when they make something from the line. But I have seen people on eBay try to disguise a reproduction as a custom to fool people, I guess. Please, if you're a collector, don't buy reproduction items. I don't care if they do save you some money. At the end of the day, like I said, when you're through with your collection and you got authentic stuff, you're going to be a lot happier. And when one day, sadly, when you're gone and something happens to your collection, it's not going to burn some other new collector coming in with buying reproduction that he thinks real. And if you can't take my word for it, take Indiana Jones. Right, Indy?
That's right, Mr. Junk.
So, till I find something else to talk about, this is me and Indiana Jones saying, check out StarWarsJunk.net.
Yeah, it's a very cool site.
Man, that's a good looking Jones right there.